Hello dear students, welcome to EVS2 class. Today we are going to learn our second lesson. But before starting our lesson, I would like to ask few questions. Can you identify this picture? Correct, Swami Vivekananda. Can you identify this picture? Very nice, Sai Baba. So students, as you have knowledge about saints, today we are going to study about great work of saints from the lesson Work of Saints. Students, the tradition of saints that begin in Maharashtra with Sri Chakradhar Swami, Sant Namdev, Sant Dhyaneshwar, Sant Chokamali was continued by saints coming from various starters of society. In this group of saints are include Sant Goroba, Sant Sauta, Sant Nirhari, Sant Eknath, Sant Sheikh Muhammad, Sant Tukaram and Sant Niloba etc. Similarly, Sant Janabai, Sant Sorabai, Sant Nirmalabai, Sant Muktabai and Sant Benabai Shirurkar also included. Students, they taught people various virtues like compassion, non-violence, charity services, equality and brotherhood. Students, virtues means having good qualities or habit. They say no one is inferior, no one is superior, all are equal. Such was the sentiment that was created by the saints in the mind of the people. Similarly, Samarth Ramdas also rendered his work in Maharashtra. In this lesson, we are going to see some great saints' work one by one. Sri Chakradhar Swami. Sri Chakradhar Swami was originally a prince from Gujarat. He came an ascetic and over to Maharashtra. He moved all over Maharashtra preaching equality. He did not believe in any discrimination based on gender or caste. Several men and women become his follower. He established his known as sect Mahanubhav. Memorable incident from his life have been compiled in a book titled Leela Charitra. Sant Namdev. Sant Namdev was a great devotee of Vitthal. He lived in the village Narsi. He composed numerous songs in praise of God, performed kirtans. Kirtans mean song and story based on religion theme. Everywhere and brought about general awakening among the people. He moved all over Maharashtra to spread Bhagavad Dharam and taught the people deep devotion to God. He instilled in them to desire to protect the religion. Sant Namdev later traveled all over India spreading the message of humanity. He traveled to Punjab and spread the message of equality among the people there. He composed song in Hindi. Even today, some of his verses are included in Guru Granth Sahib, the holy book of the Sikhs. His songs are still sang all over Maharashtra with great love and devotion. Sant Dhyaneshwar. Sant Dhyaneshwar family belonged to Apegaon. Nivrutinath and Supandev were his brother and Muktabai was his sister. A bigoted man taking care of these children because they were the offspring of sannyasi. It happened like this. Their father took sannyas and retired from the worldly life. As a sannyasi, he left home. But later on, obeying the order of his guru, he returned home and started living with his wife. Their four children were born afterwards. But the narrow-minded religion leader did not think it is right that a sannyasi should have children. Hence, they banished them from their community. Once Dhyaneshwar went around the town for begging for alum, but no one would give him any alum. He heard to listen abusive language instead. Because of this incident, Dhyaneshwar was deeply pained. He entered his hut and locked the door from inside, grieved over his lot. Muktabai came and knocked the door off and said, "Open the door, Dhyaneshwar. How can we remain drowned in our own sorrow?" These words of his sister gave him new hope. He forgot his personal sorrow and started his work. Everywhere the poor and backward people were being oppressed. In the name of the religion, Dhyaneshwar went among the people and taught them to have a faith in a God. Give equal treatment to all. Help those in trouble. Dhyaneshwar words are heard in every nook of corner of Maharashtra for last 700 years. In those days, all religion teaching was conveyed in Sanskrit book. This language of ordinary people in everyday use was Marathi. Dhyaneshwar wrote his outstanding book Dhyaneshwari in Marathi. At an early age, at Alandi near Pune, Dhyaneshwar took Samadhi. Sant Eknath carried on the work started by Namdev and Sant Dhyaneshwar. He lived in Paithan. He preached that the way to reach God was through the devotion, Bhakti Marg. He wrote numerous songs, abhangs, uvas and bhruts. His advice to the people was not to accept any distinction of high and low. He made friends with the poor and drowned people and taught them devotion to God. His love extended even to the dumb animals. One day he was going to the river for a bath. It was noon and very hot. The sand bed along the riverside was very hot too. He heard the crying of a poor child sitting on the hot sand. Eknath looked around and saw the child. He rushed to him and looked around for the child parent. He picked up the child in his arm, wiped his tear and reached him home. In this way, his personal example, Eknath impressed the message of love and equality on the mind of the people. Sant Tukaram. Two great Sant, Tukaram and Ramdas, live in Shivaji's time. Tukaram come from Dehu, near Pune. He owned a farm and also a grocery shop. His forefather used to lend money to the needy people. Tukaram drowned in the river Indrayani all the records of loan paper he had. Those gave relief to many people. He would go to the neighboring hill and sing a song in praise of God Vitthal. On the 11th day, Ekadashi, of the month of Ashad and Kartik, he would go to Pandharpur. He wrote new devotional songs, abhangs and performed kirtans. Thousands of people to listen to him. Shivaji Maharaj also attended his kirtan. He impressed this truth of the mind of the people. He made the to think. People accept him as a great religion leader and showered their praises on him. Even today, all over Maharashtra, we hear proclaiming Gyanoba Tukaram. The name of two great Sant, Sant Dhyaneshwar is called Gyanoba. Also, even today, Tukaram Geet is read in even every household. Samarth Ramdas. Samarth Ramdas. At the same time, the hill and valley of Maharashtra were filled with the echo of Jai Jai Raghuveer Samarth. Ramdas was born at Jump on the bank of Godavari in Marathwada. His birthday fall on Ram Navami, the day on which the great hero Rama was born. Narayan was his real name, but he preferred to call himself Ramdas, the servant of Rama. Through his great book Dasbodh, he taught men their way of good life. Through his Manache Shlok, he gave people lesson in good thoughts. The popularized the worship of strength. He raised the temple of Hanuman, the god of strength. He taught the people to organize themselves and fight against injustice. This gave courage to the people. The work of the Sant brought about a great awake among the people. Religions once again become a thing to be respected, and spirit of self-reliance was born. People regained the lost confidence. This great awakening among the people brought about the Sant's help Shivaji in his fight for Swaraj. Students, today we studied about great work of Sant. Hope you all understand this lesson very well. I'm giving notes in PDF format. You just copy in your EVS2 notebook. Thank you.